Tonight, people in one local town may rest a little easier. Police believe they have arrested the man responsible for more than 30 car break-ins. 4029 First told you about this story in March when 28 cars were broken into in Kibler. Police say the criminals hit 7 more cars in Van Buren a few days later. 4029's Joe Ellison is live at the Crawford County Detention Center. So, Joe, who is this suspect?
Tiffany, he's Charles Schultz, and police tell us he does not have a criminal history, but was brought right here to the Crawford County Detention Center. Now, he was arrested right here in Van Buren earlier today, and the Kibler police chief says he's been waiting for this day to come.
This is the largest rash of burglaries we've ever had.
Kibler Police Chief Roger Green says 28 car break-ins within a 2-week period in his small town is unheard of.
I've been the police chief here 8 years. I've never seen anything quite this large.
The break-ins started in March. Christina Brazil was the first victim.
To think that robberies start happening here in Kibler, it's just beyond speechless.
The criminal stole a check to the trash man out of her van.
$35. But that's not the point, you know.
It's your account number.
Yeah.
The criminals were stealing pills, cash, and checkbooks out of unlocked cars. 7 cars in Van Buren were broken into and about 15 more in Crawford County. Green posted signs like this warning residents of the danger.
Not a day goes by we don't work on this case.
Today, a break in the case.
Today was a good day. Today we got a call from the Van Buren Police Department that their officer stopped a car in Van Buren. And inside that car was some stolen merchandise from one of our thefts.
Van Buren officers arrested this man, Charles Schultz, for assault. The Kibler police chief charged him with the break-ins. Residents say they can rest easier.
I think it's great because I think they need to pay for what they've done.
Now, Kibler police tell us Schultz is only facing misdemeanor charges from them right now, but those charges could be bumped up to a felony. And Tiffany, right now, police tell us Schultz is claiming that he found that bag of stolen items behind a grocery store. Tiffany?
Okay, thanks so much, Joe. Police say they will continue their investigation to see if anyone else is involved in this case.